Assistive technology helps people to see, hear, and move. It can facilitate how we communicate and the way we connect with others. It can mean the difference between a life of opportunity or a life of dependency, between failing and succeeding at school, or between having a job and being unemployed. That makes it a powerful way to accelerate sustainable development. Some 2.5 billion people around the world require at least one form of assistive technology. Yet, for hundreds of millions of people, accessing such support remains a big challenge. In high-income countries, assistive technologies are available to 90% of people, but in poorer countries, this figure falls to just 10%. And in some countries, it can be as low as 3%. Such inequality when it comes to access makes this an important social justice issue.
Unfortunately, today there is a lack of access in many parts of the world, and the numbers are truly shocking and really unacceptable. And most people don't even realize this.
With over 20 years of leadership experience in global development, Pascal Belleveld currently heads up at Scale, where he's working to increase access to assistive technology in low and middle income countries.
So we know now that assistive technology is life-changing. Furthermore, it is fundamental to achieving the sustainable development goals. One of the underlying principles of the SDGs is leaving no one behind. How can we live up to that and truly leave no one behind if we can't even provide the most basic forms of assistive technology where they're needed, which is what is needed to ensure inclusion and participation of people in societies? Assistive technology has a direct impact on people's ability to get out of the cycle of poverty.
As something that cuts across many different sectors, assistive technology can improve people's health, education, livelihoods, and much more. It is also something that all of us might end up needing at some point in our lives.
If you think about the aging population, which is a big driver of the growing need over the next decades, everybody, as they grow old, will be in need of one form of assistive technology or another. They don't consider themselves living with a disability necessarily, but they will need AT. There are many obstacles that make access to assistive technology difficult. The first one is a lack of awareness and understanding and knowledge about assistive technology. And that concerns, you know, even people who need themselves assistive technology. They may not be aware of what exists, what's possible, what they have the right to demand, or what's appropriate for them. Their caregivers often don't know it either. The second obstacle, if you manage to raise that awareness, is then the political will to actually do something about it. And I guess the third big obstacle then is the financial accessibility, right? So even if you've got awareness, you have political will, there is still a barrier around the financing of it.
Investing in assistive technology can have enormous economic benefits for societies in the long term.
It actually makes economic sense to invest in assistive technology. We developed a business case a few years ago that demonstrated a 9-to-1 return. So for every dollar that you invest in assistive technology, there's a $9 return back to society and the economy of the country. And so it really is a smart thing to do for a country to budget and support programs around access to assistive technology.
With 2.5 billion people in need, there can be no argument that we have our work cut out for us. If we are to meet this global challenge head on, it is imperative that decision makers come together to create an inclusive environment that will allow people who require assistive technology to flourish. Only then will we begin to make access a reality for everyone who needs it.